Anti-diabetics. In today's video, we are looking at sulfonylureas. Long twisted name, but in essence, they help lower our blood sugar. And we're going to talk about how they do that right after this. Welcome back. My name is Tammy, and this is NurseMinder, and on this channel, we do everything nursing. So if you're new here, consider subscribing below so that you get the next video when it's released. Today, we are talking about sulfonylurea. Woo, that's a tongue twister. We are going to dissect that word for you. It's a classification of antidiabetic drugs. Now, before we get started, be sure to comment, share, and like in the description box below. We'd love to hear from you. First, we're going to start with a review of the pancreas. The pancreas is an interesting organ in that it has two different cell types that are of interest in terms of digestion of food. The first is the acinar or achinar cells, and they have an exocrine function in that they produce digestive enzymes to help break down our food. What we're interested in this medication is the beta cells. Now the beta cells are where our insulin is produced, which is an endocrine function. When I've got lots of sugar floating along in my bloodstream, my pancreas is signaled, the pancreas ramps up production of those beta cells and gives my body more insulin to move this glucose from the blood system into the cells. Now with some patients, type 1 and type 2 diabetes, these beta cells are not functioning at their optimum. We're going to help those beta cells do their job by taking a medication called sulfonylureas. Now we're focusing on second generation sulfonylureas because they're most commonly used in practice. I do have a list of first generation drugs here. And you'll notice that there is some similarities in the naming of the drugs. And the use IDE at the end of our first generation is also in our second generation. And so our first generations are actually used less frequently nowadays because they have been found to be less effective in managing glucose. But they've also been identified in increasing cardiovascular risk. So I'm going to focus just on second gen because that's most likely what you'll see in practice. So glyburIDE, glimepiride, glipizide. We also notice that they all start with a GLI or a GLY, so kind of glucose, glycogen, those kind of clues that this drug might be used for sugar. And IDE is the ending that we're looking for to identify it as a sulfonylurea. Now let's get started with looking at how they work. They increase insulin production. So that means these are given to patients who have a functioning pancreas. So type 2 diabetes, you may find them on this medication if they have a functioning pancreas. So how does this work? Sulfonylurea. This medication comes down into the beta cells and it says, so we need to improve the function of your work. So we need more insulin, so we're going to ramp up production of insulin. That's one way it works. The other way it works, there's a second one. So it kind of needs sulfonylurea to start. Sulfonylurea is going to bind here on the cell. It's going to enhance the number of insulin at the party. So insulin is filling up that receptor site so that glucose can then enter into the cell. Now some people use the acronyms or the visual of a cell phone. Instead of cell phone, they'll say cell phone. And that visual helps them think, well, cell phones help me be very productive. Cell phones also aid in connecting things. So if I think of a cell phone and how it works for me in a daily life, I might be able to remember that sulfonylureas help connect. So where sulfonylurea binds, increases insulin affinity, opens up those channels for glucose to enter the cell. It also is increasing productivity. I couldn't work without my cell phone. And so, I mean, even this video is being made by my cell phone. So increasing productivity in the beta cells to produce insulin. Now the best time of day to take your second generation sulfonylurea, you're on glyburIDE, is in the morning because we want to increase insulin production as glucose is rising in the bloodstream, and that rises with food. So one way to help remember is the I in IDE. It usually takes 30 minutes to 1 hour for this to start to work. So you want to make sure you're giving this before you eat. Now let's talk about side effects. When we understand how the drug works, then we can predict more accurately what we should be watching for if we take the drug incorrectly, or if we're prescribed too much, or maybe we're not eating when we take this drug, okay? So we know that this is to increase insulin production to help get that glucose out of the blood into the cells, decreasing how much glucose is circulating. So if the goal is to decrease glucose, our side effects, signs and symptoms of side effects are going to be related to this. So anything to do with hypoglycemia. So confusion, maybe we've got some headaches, some blurred vision, we're not quite feeling ourselves, hypoglycemia. We may have anorexia. If we are taking our medications and then not eating, we may notice that there's some weight loss. And of course, anything we put into our stomach can always cause us to feel nauseous, upset, diarrhea, vomiting, constipation, any of those who could be involved. In addition, it may cause us to have a little bit of gas and some discomfort. Now, with all medications, you always have to consider what other medications your patient is on. So this is often used in combination with insulin or with other oral hypoglycemics. And so we'll be wanting to monitor that sugar to make sure we're getting therapeutic ranges for our patient. With sugar levels in the bloodstream, some of the things that can increase that would be stress, illness, injury. And so as a result, if we're underneath a stressful situation, like maybe an exam at school or a big life change, our sugar levels are going to rise. And so then we need to adjust our dose of medication, but do that with the help of your healthcare provider. So as a quick summary, sulfonylureas are a second generation anti-diabetic oral medication to help manage your glucose levels. If you use the thought of a cell phone, sulfonylurea, cell phones increase productivity, so production of our beta cells for insulin. Cell phones also help improve binding and connections. So that's at that cell, where it's bringing all that different insulin to help get glucose into the cell. Until next time, make it a great day, and don't forget to subscribe and put a comment below. Let me know if this has been helpful.